understand ahimsa, as you know, ahimsa is at the three level. I had taken this topic in Bhagavad also in detail. I will touch upon it. Ahimsa is at the level of body, mind and speech. Speech ahimsa is there. But the main vritti in ahimsa is that through me, I should not become a source of anybody's sorrow. I should not become a source of anybody's sorrow. That is that. In other words, I have a sensitivity so that I can enter into somebody's heart and I can find out my which speech, my which action would have given him sorrow. My which speech, look, we rarely do himsa by physical. Physical himsa we don't do. Because if we do, other person will also do. And I'm a weak person. So why? So this is not affordable. But more than physical himsa, we do vachik himsa. And more than vachik himsa, we do mansik himsa. Mansik himsa and vachik himsa is such that I say something or I think something about someone which is hurting for other person. If other person I will come to vachik himsa. When other person, supposing other person knows what I thought about him, he will get very hurt from me. What is your thought about other person? If he knows that this you are thinking about him, then this thought will create lot of disturbance in him. So this is called the mansik himsa. Mansik himsa means the person, you know, mental hurting. How do you hurt someone mentally? You hurt someone mentally by thinking about his badness. Mental hurt by thinking only one side of his personality and not the bigger side of his personality, not the complete personality. This is how you hurt mentally someone. Hurting mentally is that way through which I look down upon in my heart. I don't see anything and the worst part of this mental himsa is there is a joy in your sorrow and there is a sorrow in your joy. We do lot of mental himsa. The exclusion, when I exclude you from myself, when I exclude you from my own self, where I don't feel that you belong to me, I don't feel that you are a part of me also. The essence of himsa is that I don't think you as a part of me. It is anti-sarvatma bhava. I feel that you are not me and not you are different from me. Bhed buddhi, when it comes, then the mansik himsa starts. And in that mansik himsa, moment your thought comes, I try to think something bad about you. Supposing somebody knows that this person is thinking so much bad about me, he would have got very hurt and he would have got very disturbed. that this person has thought very much, so much about me like that. But various thoughts about various people which you may have entertained, you can't tell this thought to others that this is what I was entertaining about you. My thought about you is this only. People internally curse or internally keep on thinking like that. Ahimsa is a vritti through which there is a constant thought flow about a person that let good happen to him. And in my mind, I count his goodnesses and not his badnesses. If you know what thought I have about you, you will never be unhappy. You will be happy. This is called ahimsa vritti. About every person that I live with, I deal with, I have a bhav of he belongs to my part. His mistakes are also my mistakes. Where he lacks, I also lack somewhere. I am not excluding him from my life and from my sight. So the tendency to accept a person mentally, the tendency to not reject a person mentally is another aspect of ahimsa vritti is there. I'll tell you one more point. Why a person becomes ahimsa? Nobody wants violence for violence. Nobody wants to be hard for becoming hard. Person becomes hard because of three vritti he has. Either he has ahankar, either he has rag, or he has dvesh. If a person has ahankar, he will definitely be a himsak person. If a person has ahankar, he will definitely have violence in his life. He will definitely become a harder person than others. Because moment his ahankar is touched or attacked, he comes in offensive mode, and the pain that he experiences, he transfers the pain to others. More pain anybody has in his life, in his mind, to that extent he will have violence or himsa in his life. And an ahankari person develops very strong pain very fast. When a person's ahankar is not respected, he develops a lot of agony inside. And that agony, he is not shy of spitting the venom through his mouth, through his speech, or through his intention. If he can't say something bad, at least mentally he will think a lot bad about that person. So one who has ahankar, I have always seen, such people are always hard. They don't bother that what other person will go through with my speech, what other person will go through with my body language, what other person may be thinking about me. They are totally immune to such kind of behavior. That is what makes a person himsak in his life. A person who has less ahankar, he has less pain in his life. One who has lesser pain in his life, he transfers less pain to others because he doesn't have pain. When we have ahankar, immediately we develop pain pocket, and that pain pocket that I develop, I am waiting for someone to release my pain on that person in the form of bad speech or in the form of some kind of emotional outburst, or mentally I will not talk to someone. Mentally I am not talking that, I am physically I am not talking, mentally I am talking a lot actually. I have a lot of thoughts during that time, and that is what makes me Ahimsa, my Himsa Vritti is not there. My Himsa Vritti is on its pinnacle and on its top, because I have to release myself on someone, and therefore I have so much of pain inside. More is the hankar, more is the pain in a person, and more sharper he will talk at that time. He will not be talking very, because he has lot of pain, so he will use such hard expressions. He will use such words that is unforgettable, that is difficult to forget, or he will have such behaviors that will be difficult to forget for another person, because he has lot of pain of being neglected, pain of being sidelined, pain of not being giving attention, pain of somebody becoming more important than me, pain of I being refuted on a certain point, pain of my point was not understood by others. So hankari person develops very fast some pains in his life, and such pains come out as hinsa in his words or in his speech. Second cause of ahimsa is when I am extremely attached to someone, I am insensitive to others. I don't bother what others think, others say, others feel. So second cause of my himsa vritti is that my extreme attachment, what others will think about me, or if my action is hurting to others, my speech is hurting to others, my behavior is hurting to others, all these things he is oblivious of at that time, when extreme attachment is there. Because attachment makes a person, people say love is blind, I say attachment is blind. Love is illuminating, love is enlightening, attachment alone is blind. A person does not, he wants so much of joy, so much of joy he wants to take and give from one person, that he doesn't know that the joy that I am taking is not as per dharma, and I am hurting somebody in some way or the other, or I may be hurting somebody. So make attachment is another reason why a person becomes bad intentioned, or his life becomes self-centered. And when you are attached, there will be someone who will obstruct your attachment. There will somebody who will say that don't get attached here. So when a person is attached, he doesn't want that somebody should obstruct his attachment. And at that time, again, I become harder. So I become harder towards other person. That is another thing that happens in our life. Third cause of ahimsa is when a person has lot of dvesh for someone. When I just don't like you, I already told being negative, when I don't like you, I want to hurt you also. My speech will be hurting towards you, my thoughts will be hurting towards you, my intention will be hurting towards you. So this is the diagnosis of himsa in our life. A nirahankari person will hurt less. When a person has less ahankar, he will hurt less by his speech. When a person has less rag, he will hurt less. When a person has less dvesh, he will hurt less. So this is the way why we hurt someone a lot. An interesting point is, sometimes agony is more, irony is not agony, irony is where I have got a lot from, that place we are not shy of hurting because of our ahankar. Mother, father, teacher, guru. We ahankari person doesn't spare anybody. He will not be a person who has sensitivity to give joy, to give more in coolness. He is blinded. So ahimsa is in general also there, and some places we should be extra soft also. Some places, in all places in general I should have ahimsa, but in certain places I should be extra soft also. Now, few more points is there. To live in this world and not hurt physically is impossible. Sometimes pesticides are used. Sometimes you may kill scorpion also. Sometimes you may kill some snake also. All these things are required because they will kill you otherwise. Even when you are eating also every day, you may be eating certain worms. Certain worms are boiled in the rice and in the various kind of dals. So don't think that it is, then you cannot survive in 100% ahimsa, because it is not possible also. It is not possible also. So that meaning you have to clearly understand that somebody is there and he is hurting you and still you are keeping quiet. That is not there. In short, ahimsa is a vritti through which you live a very, very life of expanding your eye. It is a vritti of self-expansion. The thing that this is not, you live a very sensitive life that my talking will be taken as imposition to others. Let me come to now ahimsa as the vachik level. I told about the intention level ahimsa, and I told about the bodily level ahimsa. Now I'll come to the vachik level. Vachik level ahimsa, what is vachik level ahimsa? Through my speech, I don't make anybody feel that I am imposing upon that person. Others don't feel that I am a bossy person. I am a bossy person or I am imposing on someone, others don't have this feeling. Nobody likes to be dominated by someone. There are various ways of doing the work. If I am keeping this watch can be kept here also. This table can be shifted left and right also. When a person is insistent, when a person has ahankar, on every aspect he tries to put his point and he forces others to obey him. When a person forces someone to obey him, others avoid his company. They don't want that this person should give me any opinion. Rather, a person should be that others should feel what is his opinion, let me follow that. But when a person is a very pokey kind of person, everywhere he gives his opinion without being asked, and he does not accept others' point, such people are not like they are doing verbal ahimsa. Even when you have to talk to someone, you should understand when is his other person is in mood of listening or not. Bhagwan Ram tells Purjan Gita in Uttarkhand, and then Purjan Gita he says, I am going to tell you about something, dharma. If I am wrong, please stop me. If I am wrong somewhere, please stop me. I always, 90% of our vyavahar is through our speech only. Maximum of our vyavahar is through speech. So nobody wants that somebody should talk to me in a manner which is having some arrogance in it, or which is having some kind of, he's talking too much is there, or he's trying to put his point right. All these things nobody wants. How much himsa we have done by speech, that is unimaginable. So speech is also one source. We have disturbed many people by speech. Don't think that when any defect is more, you don't realize it. It is only when your defect is less, you realize more after doing it. When I see somebody that he is doing wrong and he is not saying sorry to anybody, or he is not has any repentance about this, that means that samskara and the defect is too much in him. When your clothes are already dirty, then you don't mind some more dirt falls on your clothes and you will be fine with it. It is only when your clothes are much cleaner, and then if somebody throws even a dust on that, then you start removing that dust from your clothes and you want to be white, or you want to be whatever clothes are there. So some people say something wrong, some people do something wrong, but they are not aware that I am saying wrong here, and they are not aware that my behavior is hurting to someone. This kind of callous life, not careless, callous life, hard life. How will you please, Lord? The biggest thing I feel what ahimsa gives, it gives you the capacity to feel for others' heart. When you have the capacity to feel for others' heart, you have the capacity to feel for Lord's heart also. Then you have the capacity to feel that Lord's heart will be disturbed when I do like that, or it will be disturbed when I think like that. Lord's heart is very important for me. But because you have not practiced sensitivity with the people around, with Lord also insensitivity will be there. And insensitivity towards Lord is not the bhakti, you know. All bhakti is sensitivity towards Lord. So how will I gauge this will be liked by Lord or not when I have not practiced this gauging capacity with other person also? One word more somewhere disturbs the environment. One word which is not appropriate, it makes up the whole congregation sometimes put in head in shame. We are very free. We have never trained our mind to speak something. We don't know that this thing will be not acceptable. This is not, or I am speaking little more than others, or I am using a wrong verb. I'm using a wrong sentence here to communicate this. Or my speech will not be taken in a good sense by the people, everybody here. So better to practice quietness here. Some people don't understand these things, and their presence becomes little and a burden to the congregation, burden to the meeting, I will tell you. Why these things happen? Because a person has not practiced ahimsa at a vachik level. My personality should be such that other person should feel, he should say something. He should talk something. Let me see what he talks. And when he talks, other person keeps silent, then they are happy. Now he is talking, he will give some good point. Some people are there, you feel he may not blurt again. He may not talk, he is not stopping. He is giving opinion too much. He may be giving a right opinion, but still it may be not perceived as right. Don't think I speak right. I may be right in what I am saying, but I am over saying something. Or I may be saying at a wrong time, I may be saying that. When our sensitivity towards the person around me, in front of me, left or right to me is not developed, do you think we'll be sensitive towards the Atma, the silence of the Atma that I have? Whole spiritual life is increasing our sensitivity only. No? How much you have to tune your mind to think on the subject, to talk on the subject. How will you do that? When ahimsa is less in, I told you so many times, Bhagwan Ram, when he used to go to the forest, and if he went to see any Rishi Muni, he used to take his bow outside because he felt bow is a rajasic thing and this Rishi would be in meditation and they are working, they are in a quieter environment. So I think I should take my bow and arrow outside and then go and greet him. Then he will say to Valmiki ji, where shall I build my cottage? Valmiki ji said, well, why you are asking? He said, Muni Udveg na paavai koi. I don't want any sage should get disturbed because I am here. Because of my, we are rajasic, we are the princess. We will go out, we will sit here. It may not disturb their havan, their puja, their paath, their abhishek. It may not disturb them. Are you understanding? When you developed ahimsa with the people, then you become a devotee. Then you become a person who has sensitivity towards Atma. Because to sensitivity towards Atma is the ability to listen to silence. The silence which is inside, that is the sensitivity is there. When I can't listen to the call, that expectation that you have from me, how can I can be sensitive towards myself and my Lord? Any role demands high level of sensitivity. What is needed from my role? If I have to play the role of a teacher, I should be sensitive towards what you also need, what you need to hear, what kind of behavior you expect from me, what kind of speech you expect from me, what kind of intention you expect from me, what kind of schedule you expect from me. You are not sitting without expectation. As you have expectation from me, from you also, others also have expectation, which are a valid expectation. But a person who is not sensitive, he doesn't bother, you know. His life doesn't bother. Remember one thing, when you don't bother, nature becomes hard with you, and nature also doesn't bother about you. Some people have this attitude of not bothering. This is not a right thing, no? This is not a right thing. And those who are saints, they are of a different caliber. Their very caliber is different. They are sabke priya, sabke hitkari, sukh dukh saris, prasansa gari. They are dear to our, whom you love, who cares about your joys and sorrows, no? Whom you love, who bothers about you slightly, whom you want to live, spend your life with. You want to spend your life with that person who has given you joy, who is sensitive towards, who has never spoken harsh to you. Whom you want to spend your time with and your breakfast and dinner with. With that person only. So ahimsa vritti gauges, okay, I have to talk like that, I will definitely talk like that. My body language should not give me hinsa. Simple things alone make a life beautiful, no?